guys. Bill here. That was a random song, but what it had to do with was how they use pills and potions in mental hospitals. The jig is up. The secret to survival is Jesus. The secret is out. I don't really hear voices. I was a Christian going undercover for Jesus's people, which is us, immigrants, Americans, Spanish people, Indian people, Black people, white people, everybody in the world. The secret's out. It's in the book. Read it at your leisure. The secret's out. I don't hear voices. I'm just an actor in training. Jesus wrote my script. God wrote my script in life. This life, Jesus is the author and finisher of my fate. Jesus is my coach. There was a calling on my life back in 2000. There was a calling on my life since I was born, just like everybody that is born as a sinner. If you're going to heaven, you are already God's child. He knew you when he was formed you in your mother's womb. He called you for such a time as this. He called me for such a time as this. There is spiritual warfare. There are demons walking around in this earth to win souls for the devil. Let me say that again. There are demons walking around in this world to win souls for the devil. They do it through music. They do it through the government. They do it through hospitals. They do it through police. They do it through the army. They do it through the navy. They do it through churches. Open your eyes, stay woke. And I know you guys know this. It's no surprise. Today, people are living a lie because they don't want to live the truth. And you can go ahead and get off this video if you don't want to talk about it. But Jesus is the truth, the way, and the light. If you want to go to heaven, you got to know Jesus. Get saved. I do not hear voices. I knew what I was doing when I took my clothes off and went outside naked to pray to God. Jesus told me to pick up my cross and follow him. I'm not blaming Jesus, but he told me to pick up my cross and follow him. Now that the hard part is over, we can breathe. I can breathe. Okay. So when I was called, I was pregnant with my son, Amani. There's no coincidence that I ended up in Tallahassee. I didn't know that I was going to end up meeting Jesus and God in human form. I didn't meet Jesus yet. I did, kinda. I'm not sure yet. I know Jesus. He's been with me all this way. He's coached me. I never seen him in person. I think I saw God in person, human form. But they have been coaching me through this whole journey. The goal is to reach souls to go to heaven. The goal is to help people know Christ and to take them out of misery of this unfair world and to get to know Christ. To live a happy life more abundantly. Christ gives you life more abundantly. He teaches you who you are in Christ, literally. And you already know who you are when you find out who you are through Jesus. He teaches you who you are. What I mean by that, when I first went to the mental hospital, I ended up taking my first mental health meds, and they were filled at the tip top of the cup, and my stomach felt like it was going to explode, and I said, we got to take all these pills. And I have, there was an earth angel that was my roommate. And she's like, just take it and listen to the doctor. That's what the nurse said. She looked me in the eye and said, take it and listen to the doctor. So I realized life is a game. Never played chess in my life, but God taught me how to play the game of life. So now I know I could play. If I ever play chess one day, the way Jesus coached me, I probably could play one day. But anyway, I took the medicine and my stomach felt like it was gonna explode. And then they gave me a shot called trazodone and risperdal. And my veins literally felt like they were itching and burning. And then when I went, I think I died and came back to life because I met God. And he was playing Stairway to Heaven to me on a guitar in the porch. And then I met my true love on the patio. And he came in with the radio, the thing I love the most is music. And he came in with the thing I love the most. And you know how that movie where the man comes in with the trench coat in the rain with the radio over his head, that's how he came in with the radio. And then God was like, isn't it a good thing when you meet when you are joined together with the one you're supposed to be with? And me and him looked at each other and we nodded to God in agreement. And then I haven't seen him for 5 years, and then I prayed for him and I got this tattoo on my hand, and he wrote me 5 years later when I prayed, like, God, please let me be married one day because I miss him. And I would think about him through the bad times, you know, it got me through. Because when I was in jail, when they put me in jail for all the things that happened in the mental hospital, jail was hell. But anyway, Jesus was there. Jesus was there every step of the way. He's going to be there every step of the way. But, yeah, get saved. I'm telling you, this life is not forever. After this is heaven or hell. And I'm choosing heaven. So, yeah, the jig is up. The secret's out. I don't hear voices for real. I know what I'm doing. My pussy's out. My butt is out. My eyes are out. My my titties are out. Shit. I got more womanly body now. This grown woman weight don't play, like Portia says on Real Housewives of Atlanta. She's right. This grown woman weight do not play. My butt be jiggling when I walk, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I hope nobody's looking, but people be looking. This Haitian man followed me all the way home today when I went to the gym. It was so creepy, but I let him give me a ride to the laundromat, and then I walked the rest of the way home when I made sure he left, drove off and really left, you know. It was a little creepy, but I didn't want to walk back home. But yeah, like, it's crazy. Like, God knows. Like, God will give you dreams and all these stuff. All these dreams I had in high school, in my sleep, is deja vu happening now. And that's how I know I'm coming of age. And I know you guys have deja vu. If you have deja vu and you're coming of age, that means that you're coming of age. And if you had deja vu, right, and you're having these scenes in your life where you're like, this happened before, that means you're coming of age. That means you're catching up to yourself. You're catching up to the moment that you're meant to be at, and you don't want to miss your mark. You don't want to miss your moment. So don't live a lie. I know y'all don't want to hear me, but Jesus is coming. He's coming. Okay? He is here right now. He told me it's time to come clean, because we did this for the world, to save the world. He's going to save the world. And when everybody, and he gave me the visions of all the stuff that's going to happen to me. Yes, I know that I'm going to end up getting beat down and all this stuff by cops and racist people. All these racist people don't like me because I represent for God. I'm God's daughter, and I understand y'all don't like me, but I don't care. I love God and I love Jesus. And nothing's gonna stop me from doing what they want me to do. So y'all could just keep on doing what y'all wanna do. Cause I'm gonna keep doing God's work. I'm all about God's business. Okay, okay. So yeah. Anyway. So yeah, y'all. The jig is up. Not the jig is up, but the secret's out. The secret to survival is Jesus. Get loved by him today. He loves you. He is the answer. He is awesome. He is cool. He knows who you truly are. When I first ended up in the mental hospital and my true love came with the radio and the radio stations, he was DJing the radio stations, and he told me you could dance. You could dance through the music he was DJing. And then I was twerking for my true love in a hospital gown. I didn't care. Had no underwear on. I was like, fuck these white people. I'm gonna keep on dancing. Fuck these nurses. Fuck these doctors. Fuck these other patients. Fuck. And every time I go in the mental hospital, it's demons versus angels. I'm like, fuck that shit. I'm going to keep on dancing for my true love. And he was fine as fuck. And I'm like, yup, I'm going to keep dancing for my baby. Because I said, I'm going to be a hoe for my husband. And I said, whenever we have sex, it's going to be wild. We're going to have threesomes. We're going to have foursomes. We're going to have all that. So anyway, yep. So yeah, y'all, get saved. Get saved. Get saved. God is the business. Jesus is the business. He loves you. Let's go to heaven, y'all. Let's have fun with Jesus. We're going to praise him in heaven. Get y'all testimony right. I love y'all. Peace.